No, I mean you're preaching to the choir on that one. We kind of really agree with a lot of the stuff that you've been talking about the last few minutes, especially regarding the push into the research of PTSD. We have a couple of guys over here on the sofa who, after their deployments, went through a small transition phase that they had to deal with. That probably would have been assisted by some type of chemical compound. But
it was assisted.
They gutted through it.
Definitely would have been.
Well, Ben can claim that he's a psychonaut, so he's right up there with you with the number of trips that you've had.
I never did anything, even weed, until I couldn't find a solution for my neck injury.
Yeah.
And I had a couple of former teammates of mine that were like, "Hey, did you start smoking yet?" I'm like, "What? No." They're like, "Well, you should." And I was like, okay, I guess I'll try it. And then I was like, man, I haven't had a neck flare up from my nerve injury for the first time in 8 years. Wow, okay.
Yeah, right. Yeah. So out of all the psychedelics that you've done during that portion of your exploration in your career, what was your favorite? What was your favorite one?
Nice. Good question.
Well, mushrooms.
That's such a loaded question, dude. So none of this content is usable anymore. Dude, what the fuck's up? What's your
Give us the loadout. What do we want to go get?
Which psychedelic is best and why? What do you recommend for the children of this nation?
Do you have a name and number?
Mushrooms.
Yeah, obviously.
Amen.
For sure, mushrooms. I've just had. They're just like so dependably good and therapeutic for me, and there's just so much less stuff that you're running into in terms of like knowing you're getting the product that you're getting. You know, LSD is a really difficult compound to make. DMT is pretty easy, but still, you don't necessarily know how that's being made and finding it in the first place and everything. And the mushroom experience, I think, just has the longest term. I think it has a lot of lasting influence in terms of creating new positive changes, breaking bad habits, creating new ones, giving insights into life, making you more curious about this life and this existence.
Yeah.
In general, I think that they're really pretty safe. And you can take a bunch and have like a really intense experience, and you can take a little and microdose. There's just like a lot that mushrooms have to offer. You can do them in a therapy setting. You can do them at a concert. They're like really versatile in so many ways.
Just not at a kegger.